Hello everybody and welcome back to Friendly Fox's YouTube channel with another episode of OpenTTD. This episode is titled Further Developments. And so here at Frindingbury, which is one of the last focus points of the last episode, I'm presently rebuilding the station here at Frindingbury. However, we have lost our good rating with the town, and so we're just waiting for the rating to come back up again, probably by the end of the year. The only work I have to do is to finish off the station itself and remove one cottage, which is right here. But we'll come back to that later. And moving on down to Farnpool, I'm not really happy with how the slow lines here seem to go on for a long time before coming to Nintford. So I'm going to reroute them to serve these small towns, which presently don't have any service, as well as Tradston, which is a bigger city, which will no doubt yield positive returns within a short time. So I've already started construction here. Kenfingpool Station is pretty much complete, although it's with wooden platforms, so it's only temporary. The earthwork meant we lost our good rating, but at least the station is complete. Senway here, we have a poor rating, but fortunately, again, the station's complete. All I need to do now is finish the earthwork and construction to link the line up to the slow lines here down at Nintford. So that's what I'm going to do right now, and we've got one train going that way already, so I'm going to pause the gameplay just so we don't end up with the train backing up, going the wrong way indefinitely. So I just need to do some earthwork here to bring the track level up to standard. Here we are. And okay, and we finish off the station construction here at Tradston. The only thing that's going to be complicated now is trying to do the junction here. Just temporarily, we'll put in a flat junction. There we go. So there we go, now the entire line is complete. We now have a route through Tradston, Kenfingpool, Senway. So served by all the local trains. So the one thing I had forgotten was put some extra signals in, but this should reduce the amount of time that each train is waiting. And the lack of signals at the exit points means that the trains will alternate direction in priority. So this one comes through. The southbound train will now have access to the station, and then the northbound train will have access once so the northbound train will have access once this train clears the section. So moving the tram engine again from Brunding Hall down to Rindworth, or Rindwell I should say, that's where we're moving it to. I have an idea for it to run a shuttle service down to Trunning Hall here, which currently has no railway station, but isn't that far away from our existing line. So here comes the tram now. Now rebuilt Nintford station again to a more satisfactory design, so there's platforms on the fast and slow lines. Here's a competing company, Jacob Shepherd Limited, has started construction near Passchendaele, running a short coal operation from this coal mine to the power station down here at Hendle Ridge. But now let's get on with our own rebuilding work down at Langley. This over here is what I have in mind for serving a goods train from Hooham to all the way over here at Slapra. And this is where we're going to start the construction. I've already done some preliminary work, but there's a lot more to do. Do some station work over here at Kingsley. Replace the underpass with an overbridge. Same thing with Nelson here, building an overbridge to replace the underpass, as the overbridge is now available. It wasn't when I built this station, mind you, so that's why I built the underpass. This allows the fast trains to have their own running line, at least towards Guston. to this major junction later, but this is a layout that works for now. I also extended the railcar service. So that it now serves Grunfingly and Watford. Anyway, I skipped over most of the construction, but this is what Langley Junction looks like now. Train going there just now, so now I have to build the new station platform here at Langley. So let's get on with that. That's the iron ore train, so we need that. To be rerouted. This is just a temporary arrangement, of course, until we can build the additional platforms here at Pladhattan and the additional slow line track, which will run up to here at Floofingford. This is a new track I've just put in, which allows the goods trains to bypass Pladhattan station, and eventually I'm going to put a depot around here. There's a link now for a second goods train from Pladhattan. This goods train runs from the factory to Pladhattan itself. The second goods train will travel to the goods station here at Langley. The only thing I need to do now is put in the signals and a physical link for the new goods train when we build it. this link, so that's causing a bit of an issue there. But it shouldn't do now. Seems it's not the only train that went the wrong way. Shoot, and this is why you check to make sure the line's clear before letting a train continue along it, because now they've crashed. Oh dear. Not a good start, but sometimes it happens, and you know, once it's happened, you can't do anything about it. Put a spanner in the works for a little while. Okay, so nearly a month later, the accident scene is being cleared up. So now we've replaced the trains that have crashed. Now we can work on those goods trains I was talking about. Build them down at the depot at Great Flanville. However, the track there only allows one-way operation. So what we're doing is we're going to build them down here at Guston. Goods. And send it and we can still send it to service down here at Great Flanville as long as it services after loading the goods. So the first train is now away. And build a second one to follow. So over here at our old operation, we're going to replace the tube train with a more modern electric multiple unit. That being the Metro Camel EMU, which became available 4 years ago. Of course, the one thing I hadn't thought about when building this was a holding area for the second goods train, because it would be blocking the grain train if I wasn't holding it here manually. But the grain train is now away. A competing company has livestock being delivered from a farm, and a new competing company has also started with a livestock delivery service from this farm with a small ship, so that should help increase the goods production. Although they have their own goods barge, which takes it off to Watford. Tulsa goods train needs to service, because it's been waiting for so long. This is the last thing I'm going to do for this scenario. Here's the goods delivery, it's just arriving. First goods delivery to Slapra. Healthy income from it too. The second train shouldn't be far behind now. It's just waiting for access down to the depot for servicing. Okay, so as I mentioned, the last thing I'm going to do for this scenario, there's a small coal mine up here which can support a short coal train. And I have a spare number in the fleet, being number 66, so I'm going to build coal mine station here, Kingsley coal mine, and train 66 is going to be the delivery. Set bridge is doing very well. There's a lot of passengers waiting. Just as well, because I replaced ship one on the on our original route. Because there was no need for two vessels on this route between Hendington Docks and Great Flanville, I moved ship one. I should say I shoaled ship one off, since it was life expired anyway. And now it is providing additional service on our service between Centre Bay and Setbridge. seems Jacob is doing very well as well. He's got service running from the iron ore mine here at Flafingfield over to the new steel mill that just opened near Passchendaele, which he was already serving with a coal mine. In the next episode, we'll have a closer look at some of Timothy's operation out here. Again, this is Jacob Shepherd's operation between the coal mine here at Frintown to the power station. It's just as well, because it looks like Timothy is planning on having a third rail system. Okay, and a new locomotive just became available, the saddle tank engine, which we are going to be using for the goods train between Pladhattan and Langley. Temporarily, I've placed the depot here, exclusively for these two trains to use. So here comes the tram engine with the coal load from Kingsley down to the power station. Perfect timing too, since the other train isn't coming yet. Of course, this won't be a big money maker since that coal mine isn't a very good producer. But we're past the point where we have to worry about making a lot of money now. Anyway, I think that completes this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and there will be more from me soon.